Thanks for tuning back into the channel today. We've got something really cool. We're going to be going over the flat rate system. What is it? How do techs get paid by it? I'm also going to clear up some of the misconceptions that everybody has about it, alleviate some of the bad ideas that people think, oh, you get paid flat rate, that means you cut all the corners. No, that's not what happens. So we're going to go in through that, and I'm going to give you guys some tips and tricks on how I make it through the flat rate system and how I make money doing it. First, we're going to go over and de-rust belt the old Duramax. So first off in this video, I just want to warn you guys that this is not a video on how to cheat the system or how people can cut the flat rate system back or how mechanics are just shysters and they're going to cheat every single penny out of you. This is just going to describe on how the flat rate system works. So what is flat rate? These days it is how 95% of technicians, in the US at least, are paid. So for instance, when a vehicle comes into the shop, we'll say, just for argument's sake, it needs a water pump. You go to that specific vehicle, we have different programs online that are our book times. So the book time on that specific vehicle, we'll say it pays 3.2 hours. You get it in and you start taking it apart and it ends up taking you right at like 2 hours. Now that technician still gets paid 3.2 hours because he did it more efficiently. You still get paid what the book time pays. Now, on the flip side, if you kind of dawdled around, you took an extra, you know, poo break, or you just, you know, ran into some issues and it took you 5 hours, you still get paid that 3.2 hours. So in most circumstances, it kind of evens itself out. Then there's also going to be warranty time. So warranty time, when you work for a specific manufacturer, Chrysler, Ford, Toyota, whatever it is, they get paid a different amount of book time per that manufacturer. So because you are a specialized or certified mechanic in that specific field, you should be able to get things done in a faster time because, you know, you've worked on them quite a bit more. So when the book time actually pays 3.2 hours, your Chrysler or Ford book time might actually only pay you like 1.9 hours because, you know, you're the expert. It's not always how it works, and it kind of sucks in our respects, but the system is a little bit broken and it needs, you know, tweaked here and there, but that's how some manufacturers are able to trim a little bit of the fat off to be able to make a little bit more money on their bottom line as well. I don't blame them, but it sucks for us technicians. So if you're a technician who's starting out in the field and you get tossed into becoming a flat rate mechanic, you are going to be overwhelmed. First off, you're going to get thrown into this and the first week on the job is going to be gut-wrenching. You're going to get through Monday and you're going to make like 4 or 5 hours. You're going to get through Tuesday, you're going to make 5 more hours, 6 more hours, and you're going to be like, man, I really have to make up some time. So there's a couple of quick tricks that I can help you to make up some time as well. The first and most biggest thing that you have to think about when you work flat rate is you always have to be busy. These guys that are sitting around on their stool, no, not like this or anything, they are not going to be making money. If you're sitting there typing on your cell phone, talk to Miss Sally, whatever it is at the parts desk, then you are not making money. Anything that a normally hourly guy does around the shop, you know, they do oil changes, take out trash, that's stuff that you don't make money on. So you have to be wary of that one. So always keeping busy and make sure that you multitask. If you've got a different car sitting here in the shop waiting on parts, be bringing in another vehicle or planning out your day from there on. Make sure you check with your service advisor, service writer, whatever it may be, to see what kind of things are coming in that you need to work on the rest of the day so you can plan things out. Being prepared and planning things out is going to be the best thing that can help you. Doing multitasking, when you have that quote, you're trying to get it from the parts advisor and you're waiting on them to get that quote, be bringing in your next car. Be organizing the tools for whatever job is coming up. As you progress in your career, you are going to know that, okay, for this job, I'm going to need a 22 millimeter wrench, a 31 millimeter wrench, and that's going to come with experience. So that's why I said beginning off, you're going to be a little bit overwhelmed because you're not going to know those little things here and there, and that will come with experience. So make sure you calm down and be wary of that one. Next recommendation I'm going to have for you guys is to stay organized. If you don't have an organized toolbox, you don't have organized bays, you're going to lose money left and right, and that's in time. You got to think of it as time is your money. The better you organize and better you keep your time, the more money you're going to make. So that extra 5 minutes you try to find your 22 millimeter wrench that you left under another vehicle or you have thrown in an extra drawer because you were just in a hurry, that's going to end up losing you time. So keeping your tools nice, clean, organized, and as well as your bays nice, clean, and organized, you're going to do a whole lot better. Make sure you keep track of the same in respect to parts. When you take parts off a vehicle, bring an extra table over. I know it may take up a little bit of extra space, but organizing everything out is going to save you a lot of time and room in the long run. Make sure you keep a track of all of that. Keeping organized also leads into organizing and keeping track of your hours. Now, hours wise in the flat rate system, you have to keep track of it. Most dealerships around the nation here are still keeping track of their repair orders on paper systems, not always digitally. So you have to keep track of your hours. The system is run by people. People make mistakes, so you have to look out for yourself. So when you get done with a ticket, you make sure you fill it all out, and then you have to keep track of what hours that you make. So the software that I use, I'm going to show you here in just a second, is what I keep on Google Documents to keep track of all of my hours. Take a look at this. And this is what I use for tracking my hours. This is an online form set from Google Documents. All you have to do is create a Google form. I put in my hours, put in the day's date, I put in the RO number, year, make, and model, description of the repair, and the amount of flat rate hours that it pays, or at least that I estimate it to pay because of, you know, warranty time. So then you're going to hit submit, and then there is a responses tab that you're able to click over to once you create that form, and it's going to keep track of everything here in spreadsheet form. And then if you know how to use, you know, it's pretty much documents and Excel online, and it's going to have all your totals made in a single column over here, and then you just make a simple algorithm to keep track of the total hours. So, you know, just because everybody is human, your service writers, your advisors, they are human, they do make mistakes, so you really do need to keep track of this stuff. And this is how I specifically keep track of it. It's nice because it's here on my computer, right here in my toolbox, as well as on any online platform. So from your smartphone, your tablet, they have the Google app, or it's just anything that is pretty much internet web-based. You have access to that. So if my computer's down for some reason, I can flip out my phone and put in everything I need through Google Documents. In keeping track of that time, you also have to think about, you don't want to lose time. This is the biggest and most important thing that you as technicians want to remember, that don't make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you're gonna have to fix something for free. If you have to spend time working on a vehicle for something that you messed up or you misdiagnosed, that is gonna be the biggest, most absolute waste of time in your day. If you just hurry up, read a code, it says, oh, crankshaft position sensor correlation. You're like, oh, I guess it needs a crankshaft position sensor because that's what the, you know, auto parts store diagnosis sheet would say. No, you have to go through the correct diagnostic process. Now, starting out techs, like if you're in a lube tech position or tire center, you have to be making lists for yourself as well to make sure that you don't miss certain things. If when you get done with the job, you can't for certain say, oh yes, I tightened that drain plug, I tightened that oil filter, I aired up the tires, then you need to go back through and check it. Taking that extra 30 seconds, minute, 2 minutes, whatever it is, to check your work is gonna save you tons of money in the long run, because guarantee you, it will happen. You will miss something. You'll mess something up. So if you check back over your work, you're gonna find those things that you missed, and you're not gonna lose time, one, for you, and you're not gonna lose out on money for your shop when you forgot to tighten that drain plug, and then 3 miles down the road, it pops it out, drains all the oil out. Now your shop has to buy a $4,000 engine for that piece of junk Toyota Corolla. So don't make those kind of mistakes. For the older senior techs, same thing comes with diagnosis. When you diagnose a vehicle, you usually have gotten pretty good in the aspects of, yeah, I know what these vehicles need, you know, I see it 37 times, but that one time that you don't run through the whole diagnostic process is the one time you get your ass bit. You don't want to have that happen to you, because that's going to be another hour and a half diagnosis when the customer comes back a week later and their check engine light comes back on again. Now you have you losing time and money, the shop losing time and money, you have a pissed off customer, and you're going to have to put parts on, and your dealership's going to lose money because they have to put it on for free. Parts are free, your labor's free, you just wasted 2 to 3 hours of your week in flat rate time. So you might have just missed out on getting a really awesome job, like some tune-up, suspension work, something like that, where you could have made 5 hours. So you're 8 hours in the hole. So don't be making dumb mistakes. Always go through the whole process. If you take your time, do your whole process, double check your work, it won't bite you in the ass. Make sure you keep up on your training and do your diagnostics properly. One of the last things that you can do is to be able to put in that little bit of extra effort. I know everybody always says, yeah, I put in 110%, but what does that mean when you're working flat rate? That means when you're doing that oil change and tire rotation, you rotate the tires, you notice, oh, there was brake dust all over the wheels, and now my grubby fingerprints, you know, kind of made big old finger smudges all over the wheels. Wipe them off. It takes 30 seconds and a rag, and the tires and the wheels of the customer are going to be clean. Every once in a while, that customer will notice that little bit of extra effort that you put in, or that little bit of extra stuff that you do for a job, putting a little anti-seize on these bolts to make sure that, you know, they don't seize up further, you know, in the future. Studs, lug studs, you're gonna have these people do these jobs later down the road, and they're like, wow, this technician did a really good job putting this stuff together. Make sure you put in that little bit of extra effort, it's gonna go a long way. Last but not least, and I've alluded to it in a couple of other points in the video, is just don't become complacent. As you get more comfortable in the flat rate system, as you get more comfortable in the certain jobs that you're doing, you're gonna try to cut corners a little bit, and that's what the flat rate system is about, in trying to do things faster, not cutting corners quality-wise, but quantity-wise. Buying some of those special swivel sockets that can reach into spots a whole lot easier, rather than having to take that extra alternator off or have to take something else off. That's where your experience is going to come into play. I know right off the bat, you guys are gonna be frustrated just because you don't know those little tips and tricks of the trade, but it will come over time. Don't start cutting corners on quality and missing out on things just to start making that time throughout the week. It's not gonna be great for you. It's gonna hurt you, it's gonna hurt the dealership, it's gonna hurt the customer. So why would you wanna do that? Don't become complacent in your work, and your work will gradually get better. You're gonna learn how to do these things, you're gonna get better at them. So putting the time in is gonna get you experience. Make sure you do it the right way. Some of the things that you'll come to find out, and a whole lot of people have tried to remind me of this throughout my toolbox tour and other videos, that your toolbox and your tools, you know, they aren't gonna make a good technician. No, that's true. Your training will. If you do your training right, you keep up on your training, it's gonna take care of you. You don't cut corners, and you don't cut corners on the quality of work that you do. Your work's gonna, you know, blossom into something that's a lot faster, and your employer is going to notice it as well. The better work, the least amount of comebacks that you have, your employer is gonna have more trust in you. Generally, they're going to want to give you more money. So that's going to help you in the long run as well. So those are the tips and tricks that I had for you guys. The flat rate system, it is kind of a crazy thing and you're going to be overwhelmed by it. Just follow these few simple tricks and you will come out on top. I promise you that. I've been doing it for 10, 11 years now, and the system is working for me. It can work for you too. I'll probably do another video sometime in the near future on what I think is broken and what needs repaired in the flat rate system as a whole, but that's for another video and for you guys to tune in and figure that one out. I appreciate you guys tuning in. That's all I got for you today. If you like this kind of content, make sure you hit the thumbs up, make sure you hit the subscribe, and make sure you turn on that bell notification so you can get notified of when I come out with cool, awesome new content for you guys to enjoy. I appreciate it. Thanks again, and you guys stay awesome.